Last year, we got married in Spain and we planned the wedding of our dreams. I think both of us were very detailed. We like things to be personal and meaningful, so we went to some crazy extent to design the wedding of our dreams. And the wedding dress was no exception. As an architect, I wanted the dress to represent the location where we were getting married, which was a medieval, very small medieval town in Spain. It was a very simple dress, very plain in materials, no decoration, but I feel that if you know the story, then it is quite more interesting than what it seems. Sigüenza is a beautiful medieval place, and when we think of it, there are two buildings that pop to mind. One is the castle, and then the other one is the cathedral. The cathedral is an incredible building dating back to the 12th century. Three parameters from this cathedral inspire the dress. The cathedral is characterized by two prominent towers, semicircular arches, very typical of, you know, the sort of Romanesque architecture in Europe, and very delicate rose windows. The dress had two very prominent blocks or lines coming from the waist to the very back of the dress to the end. It had an open back and it was exactly the same geometry as the arch of the entrance. And then, mimicking those beautiful rose windows, I had some very detailed buttons that were quite visible within the dress. You'll see about 80% of the dress just being opaque, being really dense, and the fabric representing that very well. But then the second part, maybe that 20%, it would be reflecting the Gothic architectures. So there's one little detail of the dress where, you know, that fabric becomes a little bit lighter, the sleeves. The sun from the sunset would actually have to go through the sleeves, and then that would look really nice. So you could almost, you could see my arms a little bit, not too much. And number three, mass and volume. Cathedrals in the 12th century had to be sturdy. They had to resist their own weight load, and the dress had to represent the foundations of our marriage. So yeah, there's a lot of fabric. Now, the other reason why the dress has so much fabric in it is because I wanted to give it a second life. At the moment, the dress is being tailored into a little blouse and trousers, and the remaining fabric will be used for the christening dresses of our future children.
Hello.
Do you want to share the news?
Ooh, okay. We are expecting.